أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين وصل على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين وصل على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. Beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, brothers and sisters in humanity, I greet you all this day with the greetings of peace and love. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be with each and every one of you. I'll start by talking about gratitude and a shukr. And this great scholar of Islam, Imam Muhammad ibn Ahmad al-Jawzi, he mentioned Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. All praises is for Allah, Lord of the worlds. That is how he started basically talking about the beginning of Al-Fatiha. And he says that there is a difference between Alhamd and a difference between a shukr. He said that in some cases that Alhamd, it's basically more general than a shukr. So he said a shukr, for example, it exists only as a reward of the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has basically bestowed upon us. As for praise, it is the reward for the thanks, and also it is an initiation of exalting the Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in this context, he's saying that alhamd and praise, when we say alhamdulillah, it's much more general than actually saying a shukrillah. Also, he highlighted that in some case, a shukr and gratitude, saying a shukrillah, is much more general than a praise, basically. Why? Because he said that praise only occurs by the tongue. As for a shukr, it occurs by the tongue and also by the heart and also by the limbs. And this is what we will explain later on. In addition to this, beloved brothers and sisters in Islam, brothers and sisters in humanity, if we understand alhamd, the term alhamd in its generality, then you would have learned the saying alhamdu is exalting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It implies exalting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for who He is, for His knowledge, for His ilm. We exalt Him for His ilm and knowledge that nothing is concealed from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We exalt Him for His wisdom, and nothing, subhanallah, is like the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We exalt Him for His grandeur and His might. We exalt Him for His generosity and all of His attributes. And also this includes the meaning of the 99 names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to end this point, I want to say that we also exalt Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because He, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has brought to the creation many barakat and blessings and the mercies that He has descended upon us. The other aspect of a shukr and gratitude that the great scholar of Islam highlighted, he mentioned the types of shukr. So there are various types of shukr. He says a shukr bilisan. And that is basically exalting the bestower of the ni'mah and the blessings by speaking about the blessings that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with. Allah says, فَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. As for the bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the ni'mah of Allah, speak about it. Speak about how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has intervened in your life. And also the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says very beautifully, التحدث بالنعمة شكر وتركها كفر. He says, speaking about the ni'mah and the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is gratitude, is thanks, and denying it, leaving off, subhanAllah, speaking about the things that Allah has blessed you with is considered to be denial of those blessings if you choose not to speak about it, and it's somehow paramount to kufr and denial. And then he talked about gratitude of the al-a'dha, shukr al-a'dha, and that is thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your limbs. And this is through acts of devotions, our prayers. We submit with our bodies, we prostrate. Our subhanallah, our acts that involve subhanallah, our limbs. Also, like for example, Hajj. It's a way of showing gratitude to Allah. And also he highlighted leaving off disobedience, leaving off wrongdoing is also a shukr bil a'dha, because you acknowledge that the body that you are blessed with, you acknowledge your hand is a blessing from Allah, your eyes is a blessing from Allah, you are a blessing from Allah, and as such that you do not want to see yourself fall into ma'asi and wrong. And this is one way of showing gratitude. And then he mentioned a shukr bil fu'ad or qalb, and this, he says, this is knowing that the numerous favors that you receive comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and as a courtesy, and not because you're entitled for it. So a person thinking about the blessings that he or she has, he knows that Allah bless you with this, that you are not entitled for these blessings, and this is coming as a courtesy from Allah. This is coming as a rahmah and a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And after speaking about the types of gratitude, he also speaks about the categories of thanks. And he says that there are gratitude and thanks that is displayed for the material things that we enjoy, and also, for example, our property, for example, our vehicle and whatever that we have. And also he says thanks for the religious blessings. Blessings, for example, the knowledge that you enjoy. The blessing for the taqwa that Allah has blessed you with. The blessing for the iman that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with. So he says, blessings for the religious barakah that Allah has blessed you with, and also blessings for the, subhanAllah, gratitude for the worldly things. And then he made mention gratitude for the afterlife blessings. And that is reward in an extraordinary way for the little work that we are doing, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us al-fawa'id and benefits that we cannot imagine, and we cannot see in no way or in form that our actions that we engage in is equivalent to the blessing that Allah has blessed us with. And he also highlighted the stations of gratitude. And the station of gratitude, he says, thanks for the blessings that reach you specifically. So that's the first station. Gratitude and thanks for the blessings that reach you specifically. And then he mentioned another station, thanking Allah on behalf of His creation for the blessings that reach them all. So you take a moment, not focusing only on the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has blessed you with, but also you think about the blessings Allah has blessed others with, and you take that moment to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for that blessing. And the last point I would like to mention concerning gratitude and thanks that was highlighted by the Imam is basically the degrees of a shukr and gratitude. And the first degree that he highlighted, he says the shukr al-awam, and that is the gratitude of the general public. And that is when someone generally says, I thank you, O Allah, for the blessings that you have bestowed upon you, and then upon me. And then you have the gratitude of al-khawas, the elite type of gratitude, and that is the thanks of the blessing and the adversities, the blessings, and also the heart. hardship and the trials that Allah has placed in you, that you do not look at it as a niqmah, you do not look at the adversities and the hardship as a punishment, but you look at them as a blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you thank Allah for the barakat, and you also thank Him for, subhanallah, for the trials and tribulations that He placed in front of you. And the last type of gratitude and shukr that he also highlighted was a shukr al-khawas al-khawas. And that is the level of the elite of the elite. And that is when a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lose sight of all the blessings that Allah has bestowed upon them. And their focus become a primary one, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The primary focus becomes the creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they look at the bestower of the blessings rather than the blessings itself. So I hope and pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward all of you immensely, inshallah, and I hope that you have benefited from this session. Inshallah, tomorrow we will discuss about God consciousness, and we will continue the text that we started today. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.